What's up, everyone? I am doing an unboxing video for the Amazon PlayStation 4 Elite controller. So just got it in, unboxed it, got it all synced up. I played around the Apex with it, and it was quite different since I'm used to playing the PlayStation. And so I just got to get used to the Xbox style controller again, but it does help with reachability and competitiveness in some aspects when you're playing certain games. But PS4 controller, in my opinion, is better. So for the time being, I was using the Collective Minds bump paddle sticks that are on the back, which work perfect for if you want that scuff type feel. It's almost as if it was built to the controller. Like, it responds so well. The only thing I didn't like about this is that I have to have it connected the entire time to the PlayStation. Versus with this one, I'm getting it and I'm hoping that I don't have to keep it constantly connected. So far so good. It hasn't had to be connected at all. I just connected it just to sync it to the PlayStation like a regular one. And it works. It's got four paddles on the back. Programming is easy. I literally did it in the middle of a fight. Basically, team died because of me. But anyway, so all you gotta do is press and hold the set button for 3 seconds, and then I'll just do it. Light's gonna start beeping, and then you go up here, press the button that you want, and then you press the key, and then it stops beeping. And now you can hear it responding. It programs it. And so I'll go to training just so you guys can see how it plays, like in combat, things like that. So far, I haven't had any input lag or any type of negative effects so far. It feels a lot lighter than the standard PlayStation 4 controller. It's probably about half the weight. It feels a little bit cheaper in a sense because it's lighter, but it does seem like it's pretty good quality. I like it a lot so far. And spinning, right paddle stick is squatting. Spinning, everything's, has a lot of versatility to it with the sticks. I'm probably gonna have to adjust my sensitivity because the sticks have a wide range now compared to the other one, the smaller range. I don't know if that's good or bad yet. I typically keep my sensitivity fairly high, so I'm probably gonna have to lower it to like maybe a low. Yeah, that's a little bit better. And I have two extra paddles on the back that I haven't programmed yet that I probably could start using. I don't know what I'd use them for, maybe to reload or switch weapons faster. But...
inside the territories, you can find supplies that carry weapons and resources you will need to survive.
One of the best things you can use paddles for on the back are for, like if you're running, you want to sprint and turn around, you can... I'm just kind of abusing it right now. Responding pretty well. Touchpad's pretty nice. It's responsive. See if the share button works. Share button works. Perfectly fine. Alright. Let's see how it works with weapons and rapid firing and things like that.
Inside this supply bin, you can find the weapon and ammo. Depends on gold.
Doesn't seem to have a vibrating feature in it. Actually, it does. It does. I lied. It vibrates, but it's not as much as the PlayStation controller's vibration features, which is really good because it's not vibrating close up your shots. For me, at least. Now, I did say it's an Xbox style controller, but the buttons are still in the PlayStation format. And so you don't have to get used to like the X or X being on the left or shit like that. Because that just wouldn't make any sense. So let's see something. Yeah, So yeah, so far so good. It plays just like a regular controller. It has a normal and program switch. So when you switch it to normal, pretty sure.
Got it. I got it on normal. They're not working.
Then you
switch it over to program, and they're back to working. So that's what those buttons mean.
Mode 1 and 2. Pretty sure those are just quick modes. So you can program one mode, program the second mode. And so I imagine you could have like two different games programmed to this, basically, to where, you know, and you play Halo this way, or you play God of War this way, and then you play Call of Duty this way, you know, something like that. I don't know why it uses paddles with God of War, but you know, to use it on. I've seen also different models of this type of thing. A lot of people did reviews on it, and one thing they didn't like about them was that the paddles touch the ground, but as you can see with this one, the paddles do not touch the ground. So when they're sitting, they won't be pressing buttons. It's got a standard USB port. It's all plastic. Seems like it's all ABS plastic. If you want to see the model number, it's right here, so you guys can look it up, find it. So I haven't checked out the battery yet on it, but I mean, it's fresh out the box and it's been on ever since, and I haven't charged it, so there's not really a lot to say there. Let's see if the speaker works on it. That's not the speaker, but I was wondering why the light bar wasn't too bright. Oh, okay, so every time I move this, it will adjust the sound. And so we'll hear it from you. Yeah, okay, so far, this is probably one of the best ones I've seen. It has built-in speaker, audio jack, which you can actually see through the light, and the audio jack works. I was just using it last game, it was perfectly fine. It was actually louder than my PlayStation 4 controller, so I had to turn everything down. I'm not sure if it was because of the Collective Minds Strike Pack, because that thing does mess with your audio. I would recommend using it with like any expensive headphones like that one. So I just use like a regular audio jack, but now I can go back to my headphones now using this controller. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Buttons look kind of different, but I don't really play for the buttons. I play for, you know, bragging rights, really. Yeah, this is great. I like it. Definitely recommend picking it up. I got it for like $70, $68, $70 on Amazon Prime. Literally got here the next day, so. Yeah, don't be afraid to buy it, guys. I'm probably one of the first ones to review it. Thanks for checking me out. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Yeah, it's really nice. I'll do an update video in the coming months. Look for that if it's not out already, to let you know how it's been performing. But so far, it's pretty nice. It's actually lighter than my PlayStation 4 controller. I'm excited.